All right, if you have a mini truck and you're looking for that angle kit, let me tell you, you're not gonna find it. There's so much trucks out there that are needing a kit to have more angle to drift. There's some solutions, but I'm gonna tell you my solution for this. You don't need to cut any part of your truck or anything, and it's cheap. Let me show you what I did. Okay, first, you gotta go straight to eBay. There's a kit for BMWs, E36, I think is the BMW. There's a kit that they sell for that. It's just a little piece. Man, this jack is heavy. All right. That's all you need to buy, that little kit. I'll be putting a picture so you know which one I'm talking about. Now, you get that kit, $35, $25, I don't even know how much. It's below $40, right? Just gotta get that. And then you gotta do some modification to that little kit, right? But it's gonna work. I'm gonna show you what you need to do. All right, my truck is a 1992 Toyota pickup. Now, this application I think is gonna work for Nissans and Mazda B2200. The suspension that my truck has is the torsion suspension. So I believe as long as you have a torsion suspension, all the front suspension components are kind of the same. I think it's gonna work for those trucks, but I'm doing it for my application, which is a 1992 Toyota pickup. Now let me show you guys what I need to do. First, take out the tire, then stick out the tie rod. Now is where the modification comes along, right? So you see the picture of the part that I told you guys, right? This is what I make with it. It's gonna be the left and the right sides, right? So, why you need to cut it? On mine, you need to cut it because if not, it's gonna go all the way down here and it's gonna touch this ball joint and it's not gonna work. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it right there and then I'm gonna put the tie rod in here. But, you gotta have in mind, you need to cut these. This is so they put that so this part is gonna touch in here. It's not gonna steer more that way. So you need to cut it. So let's say I cut that part. I couldn't because all I have is a handsaw and it's gonna take forever to be done. So I'm gonna come back later. I don't have electricity right now, right here. I'm gonna come back later and I'm gonna cut that piece. But just to show you guys, now this hole right here, it needs to be up a little bit so it will fit the tie rod. Okay, now the other part, just place it right there. I'm gonna put the bolt for now. Okay, I'm clamping this down because once I tie the bolt, just try to get some space between there, and I need that as tight as I can. So I'm gonna tie that down with this clamp. Make sure it's really tight in there so it won't go anywhere. Okay, everything's tight. I'm gonna put this pin back because this is the one that I have. Gotta put a new one, but this is what I have right now. Just to show you guys. Okay, so this is how it's gonna look. It's gonna have those two parts. So the main purpose is having the tie rod a little bit back here, so you will have more angle. So we're doing this little part. It's all tight, all good. Now, I need to cut that, but I don't have any power in here. I will have to update and get something to get power in here from my van, and I will get it. I'm probably gonna cut it. Now, once you do this, you need to align the truck because obviously it's gonna push a little bit far. In this case, it's gonna push more because of the way that the setup is, but you can align that back and everything will be good. Now, I don't know if you guys can tell, but look at that massive angle that I got. Tire is way up there. Gotta make sure there's nothing touching. like right there. I don't know if you guys can see it. Probably not. Right there. The tire is touching on the sway bar. That's okay. And the brake line. That's okay. I can fix that. But just to let you guys know, look at this massive angle that I'm getting. I mean, I don't know if the camera can tell it, but it looks like it looks like the tire rod just broke, but it's actually not. Now to the other side, it's gonna attach in here. I need to cut these. Let me show you how it looks to the other side. All right, let me go to the other side. So that's how it goes, because we still need to cut that little part in there. See where the nut is touching? I gotta fix that. And probably cut this part right here too. But once I cut that, it's gonna go full all the way to like where it hits probably the sway bar link. So I'm gonna have a massive angle right now. Now I'm gonna do a little alignment just to have the tire straight so I can run it to the alignment shop. Increase this a little bit more. I'm gonna leave it right there right now. It's not straight, but I need to come back because I need to cut those pieces. And I don't wanna take it out right now because I gotta put it back and then take it back again. I'm not driving the truck. So I'm going to leave it like this right now. But the next following day I will be coming and make it as straight as possible as I can. And then drive it to the alignment shop, get a line, get all that cut, and then test drive the angle kit. You guys can do it, I can do it. Look where I'm at. That's my rig right there. Everything's possible if you put on your mind and you work for it. All right, so the next side, I'm gonna take the tire out already. I'm going to take this pin out. Try not to break it because I'm gonna be using it. Probably gonna put a new one. Doesn't matter, but you don't supposed to reuse this. I finally got it out. Not complete, obviously. All right, let me take. Let me get this bad boy in here. Okay. I'm gonna cut this. It's pretty loose. All right, it's out already. Now we look for that little piece. And the bolt right here hiding. Okay, so right there. You gotta cut, you gotta reopen. Put that. Little update, I don't know if this is gonna work. Why? Mainly one reason, because I can't get the tire aligned properly. So right now the steering wheel is straight, this should be straight, and I still have a little bit to adjust. I'm probably gonna be able to do something so I can adjust it, but it requires a little bit of fabrication. Now the other side, I haven't even touched it, and still a little bit like going to the left. So with that being said, this is a project that maybe works, hopefully. And if it doesn't work, well, I'm just probably gonna get some OEM spindles. Those are really easy to cut and weld and do fabrication on them.
I buy the one that is 2-inch drop, so that's why I don't want to cut these ones. So with that being said, I want to show you guys my little new setup that I have, because I have to do something so I can keep working on my project and I can keep doing everything that I'm doing right now. This is my personal shop. I'm not gonna use this to make money right now besides working on my little truck and my projects. Here it is. It is gonna be dirty because I've been walking back and forward, but pretty much this is what I have for my setup. I have my jack in there. Jack stands are on the back of the pickup. I have a little shelf that comes with it that I'm putting some stuff in here, like oil. This probably fell down, like oil, some extra lights and stuff, some stuff in there. You know, I've tried to store everything. I had the bottom part of my toolbox in there. I have my chair, I have my creeper, obviously safety first. And it's pretty much good, it has a lot of space. You can see, I still have plenty of room in here. I'm probably gonna be doing a tire rack somewhere around here, because when I hit the track, I need some tires. So I'm probably gonna do that right quick. Just a simple tire rack, or I don't know. I'm still working on everything. So I close this. I'm gonna take that step out because I need to get to the hitch. All right. Now I'm done for the day. I'm gonna close all these and leave. So next following day, I'm gonna make sure I can do the required adjustments so I can have that little setup running. If I can't get that running, like I say, I'm just gonna get a new spindle and hope for the best. So this is how it looks on the inside. You can't see everything on the back. I have a little mess, but I've been trying to organize and go around at the same time. So that's why I have the mess. Now this is pretty interesting. I guess this is coming from actually ambulance, because it has some stuff in here. But they have some setup. Like this is gonna be my real light. That's pretty good. And then this is just gonna be the lights in here. And then a lot of more stuff that I don't know. I gotta make sure this works. I wanna see if I can speak through it. But yeah, it's a pretty good vehicle for what I need. I was really needing something that I can store and take my truck to the tracks and everything. So this is a E350 with a 7.3 diesel. So it's pretty strong. It has plenty of power right now. So that's pretty much what I need. Let's hear this beast right quick. Start has a lot of miles, but it's good. Oh yeah, that's a real American power in there. All right, I'm gonna update you guys later, see if I can get that situated. If not, I'm gonna look for another way to get more angle, because I need more angle so I can go slide more on the track. So far we've been good. I'm waiting on some parts, and hopefully they got here soon. Actually, I need to check something. Bye.